things that Fiji is concerned about, whether it be their economy, whether it be the health system, whether it be like us, the tsunami of health problems that are coming, unless we do something about it. And we look, there's work to be done. We hope by the end of the day, where a statement of what our discussions entail. Otherwise, we'll be in danger of shutting the gun before we've even consulted with some people. And we're not going to make that mistake.
I understand that you've met with the AG and the Minister for Defense this morning. Would you like to elaborate on some of the highlights of the discussion?
Well, I suppose the highlight is the agreement of the Minister of Defense and the new Foreign Minister to work with us, not just on the problems that we face together, but the big problems of the Pacific. And I suppose the understanding that we'll do a whole lot better helping our neighbor if we all work together and whatever our differences, but try and be positive about the ongoing developments going forward. We know that there are countries that can help immensely in the Pacific. Our job is to provide them with the leadership and the direction and the confidence that in joining in partnership with us, we'll get the job done in a lasting way, and in many cases for enduring results that will go 50 years and beyond if we follow that pathway. And Foreign Affairs New Zealand is up to it. We've got the skilled people to do it. We're well on the way to getting the resources to do it. Our job is to ensure that we work in tandem with Pacific countries on the basis of that. If I make a phone call, somebody will answer it. No, I'm just joking. On the basis that what we are setting forth are real positive initiatives that can sustain investigation by our taxpayer base back in New Zealand.
With Fiji's Prime Minister finally agreeing to come back to the forum this year, are you sensing a turning of the tide in terms of his relationship with New Zealand and Australia?
Well, the past is the past, but we have made no bones about congratulating Fiji on the two successful elections, 2014-2018, that we have to put the past behind us because the challenges and demands that face us scream out for attention now. And so that's, how shall I say, we are pleased to see that they'll be at the forum of the world.
How concerned are you that a major New Zealand company has lost a tender here in Fiji to a Chinese company?
Which company?
Fulton Hogan.
Well, look, I can't. I don't know enough about that tender. Well, what was the advantage or disadvantage they couldn't have? What was the nature of the decision where they failed to win the tender? I can't really, with any precision, tell you and give you an answer.
I understand you've been briefed on it, Minister, but if there's...
Well, a briefing is one thing, but a thorough, credible economic analysis of what went on behind closed doors, I never got that briefing out.
In terms of looking at New Zealand's interests in the Pacific, would this not be one of them?
Well, again, any engagement we have here has got to be under successful governments for the advantage of the local people and the interests of local people. We have not, in general, taken the view that our aid comes with these massive strings, namely, if you don't have us, we're not giving you the money. We never said it. I'm pleased about that. Mind you, you can go too far in that respect. All I can say to you, I'll find out more. But at the time I've had here briefly, I've not been able to get the information exactly to you.
Do you have any concerns about China's influence, especially here in Fiji?
Well, again, we welcome China's influence and its interest of the local people and its interest of security and economic development in the Pacific. We welcome the influence of any country that is seeking to ensure there's a positive outcome in favour of the local people first.
You met with the Minister of Defence. What's New Zealand's role with their review of military laws and how did that come about?
Well, you'll know that they've had some problems with international peacekeeping in the UN. New Zealand can be of enormous assistance in getting past this serious snag, and we've got to help out in that respect. And in the big long term picture, we're in serious talks about how we might better improve their military utility in the interest of peace and security in our part of the world. So it's a serious conversation, not complete yet, but we have left them to know that we want to help them, and that we've got the facilities and we've got the people. That many of these people have already trained with in past times in New Zealand to improve the circumstances for them.
You have mentioned in the past, and you said earlier that the past is the past, that we have mentioned in pre-2014 about concerns you had about Fiji's military. They're improving then?
Well, the last thing I'm going to come up here and give you some paternalistic judgmental view of what's going on locally. We are a Pacific nation, we understand the cultural sensitivities of that. All I was pleased to say is that this trip is a seriously meaningful one. Really valued the discussions we've had. My officials are seriously positive about it. We're beefing up our local high commission here with much better resources, possibly with improved high commission base as well. That's how seriously we take it.
Mr. Peters, on the domestic issue, what is the government going to do about Jeannie Shipley remaining on high profile boards? For example, can you remove her?
What are you doing? What's going to do about it? I've been telling you for years. I've been telling you since the wine box inquiry and the PNZ scandal about this person's incompetence and the incompetence of a number of National Party people to actually understand business or to represent our country properly. What are you going to do about it? I've got a clear conscience. I've told the rural people for decades what's wrong here, and here you've got a screaming example of it.
How safe is public money?
It's not.
What do you think of her still being Dame? Is she fitting on that title?